Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I am here with one of my good friends, Wolfie Cindy. And today we created this really fun, quick holiday makeup look. I honestly had no idea what I wanted to create today, but I was like, you know what? The holidays are coming up, so let's do a red lip and just a pretty little eye. And so I'm really excited to show you guys how we created this look. If you guys haven't already subscribed, make sure to click the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up.
I feel like a flight attendant.
And don't forget to comment and let us know what you think of this look. Check it out. Hey guys, so we are starting off with Marc Jacobs Youth Quake Moisturizer, and I've been loving this a lot lately. Let's apply some here, the chin, the neck. So we're gonna fill in your brows. I mean, I know you like your brows to be like nice and thin, so we're only gonna do a little bit of filling here and there. And I am using the Anastasia Brow Wiz in dark brown. Some Anastasia brow gel. We're gonna be using a lot of warm, like red, orangey tones. So here I'm just using a cream concealer. This is the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, and this is in the shade Ginger. And I'm just gonna take a brush. I don't want it to be too heavy, so I'm just gonna apply a little bit on her lid. And I'm just gonna buff it out with a clean brush. All right, you guys, so I'm gonna set her lids with a little bit of translucent powder. And of course, Laura Mercier. So I'm taking my favorite palette. You guys, this is janky, old, but this bitch has been through it with me. And it's my favorite Vizart makeup palette. This is what it looks like. It has all these amazing shades. And if you guys don't know about this brand, then you definitely need to check them out. Their matte shades are impeccable. Honestly, a lot of artists, pro artists, have this in their kit. So just taking a brush, buffing brush, and we're just gonna apply this in her lids. So I'm taking this deeper shade here on a dome brush, and I'm just gonna brush this along her lash line. And for some reason, I like to start off with my matte tones first and then add my shimmers on top to create the base first. I feel like I have a little bit more control over the look. So it's super just slightly buffing it out. I usually like to bring my darker tones into the crease over here, but I'm gonna leave that open because I wanna brighten this area. So I'm only gonna focus the darker shades on the outer edge. So I just wanna have like a very light base with the eyeshadow. I'm gonna go in with my Dazzy X Katie palette, and I'm gonna use that darker shade. And I'm just gonna line her lash line with this a little. And I'm just focusing the darker tones on the outer edges of the lash line. So now I'm jumping to my favorite palette, an iconic bronze palette. And this is by Kylie Jenner, Kylie Cosmetics. You guys can see, I will be taking this pretty burnt shade here. What I'm gonna do is get some Max Fix Plus and spray the brush and just apply it on the lid. I'm just gonna add a shimmer to it because why not? And I'm taking this Tom Ford palette here, and this is in Golden Mink. I'm gonna do a wing liner on her, a baby one, but we'll do this off camera. So now I just wiped off the eyeshadow that fell out, or the fallout, and we are just gonna moisturize a little bit under her eyes. We did the wing liner off camera because Jesus had to take the wheel. So for foundation, I'm gonna be using La Mer, and I'll be mixing it up a little bit with the Dior Aerosol, and this is what I've been loving lately as a combo. So I have depotted my liquid highlighters into little tubes like this because I feel like it's easier to just carry around. But this is Giorgio Armani, and this is I think it's like a gold liquid highlighter, and I like it because it's really good for olive skin tones, but I don't use too much because it is a little pigmented. And so I just take my little dropper, probably like 2 drops, get some La Mer. I'm already running out, but a little bit of the Dior Air Flash. I'm first gonna mix these in together, then mix it in with the Dior Air Flash. So I'm just gonna start from her neck. Usually these parts here are a little bit lighter because the sun doesn't get to see it often. And I'm gonna be mixing 2 of my favorite concealers at the moment, and these are the Makeup Forever HD liquid concealers, and this is 42 and 40. I'm just gonna take it on my hand. And I don't want it to be too heavy, so I'm just gonna take a brush and apply it with a brush. So whatever is left with the foundation brush, I'm just gonna tap in to make sure everything is nice and blended. To set her under eye, I'm using Huda Beauty's Easy Bake Powder. These are really good. So we're only gonna just set a little bit under the eyes wherever it's needed, because I wanna keep it nice and like glowy, you know? So I'm taking my favorite Desi highlighter, and this is the Desi X Katie highlighter in Fuego. I'm taking a lip brush, and I like to use lip brushes to apply like the inner highlight. So I'm taking my favorite bronzer, and what I like about this brand is they have a lot of different shades. This is like one of them right here, but they have different from light to dark, and I like it because it has a lot of red tones in it. And this is a Japanese brush. Don't remember the name, but it's my favorite brush. And just for like an overall glow, I'm taking Milani Cosmetics Rose de Oro. Alright, so of course we all love this blush, and this is the NARS Orgasm blush. For highlighter, I'm taking this Tom Ford sheer highlighter duo, and this is in Reflex Guilt. So this is my all-time favorite powder to set the face, or at least the under eyes. And this is a Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finishing Powder, and this is what it looks like. And this is in the shade number 2, medium. I'm just gonna take a blending brush like this and just kind of like dust off whatever powder was left over from the baking, but also kind of just blending in the highlight, the blush, and the bronzer all in one. And this is really good for people with textured skin because I feel like this powder just blurs out those little imperfections. Curl your lashes. Some mascara. This is NARS Climax Mascara. So I'm going to be using two different lashes. These are Kiss 03 lashes right here, and I'm going to use this as a base. I'm taking lashes in a box, and this is number 14. What I like to do is I like to place these right here at the corner, more so at the outer edge to give it that like catty, like a flutter look, yeah. Basically. So I feel like this lash kind of just gives like a little fill in those little sparse areas. So then I'm gonna go into this in here. And what I like to do next is get some eyelash colors or whatever. So I don't think I'm gonna do any like bottom eyeshadow because I kind of like the way your eyes like looking really nice and lifted. So we're just gonna probably put like bottom mascara. I'm only gonna put it on the outer edges. So that way you keep the lightness here. It slightly goes into a darker tone. So now I am gonna go ahead and line her lips. And this is by Makeup Forever in the shade 712 Either Cherry. I'm going in with my Anastasia Beverly Hills lip palette, and I'm just gonna apply a little bit more of a richer color. This one right here. Set your face. A little Fix Plus. Close. I'm gonna apply a little highlighter on her collarbones. Alright, I'm done. So guys, this is the final look. I am so happy with the way it turned out. What about you?
I love it. This is like my everyday makeup, so.
I mean, honestly it is.
Low key.
You look really good in a red lip.
Yeah, it's my favorite.
But yeah guys, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to follow us on Instagram at Makeup by Samuel.
And Wolfie Sunday.
Peace out. Love you.